The battery was built in 1810. The battery produced a constant electric current, opening the way for many others discovered and inventions. It also provided power for the telegraph and telephone industries.
Not that battery!
The battery was built in the year 1812 along with six other batteries, or metallo towers, in Loch Swilly. The English built them in fear of a Napoleon invasion.
Who's Napoleon?
Napoleon was the Emperor of France, and he was taking over all of Europe, and the British were worried that they would be next, so they built all of the towers.
All six battery towers were built in different locations, one in Rathmullan.
The batteries were kept manned up to the end of the First World War. The six towers formed what was called the Swilly Defences during the war, and each had huge guns that protected the British fleet as it laid at anchor in Loch Swilly.
How to fire a cannon. Pour gunpowder into the cannon. Put your cannonball into the cannon. To fire a cannon, a smouldering piece of thick string called a stow. To light the cannon, get a match and place it on the touch hole. Put the match in the cannon and gunpowder will explode. When the gunpowder explodes, it pushes the cannonball straight out the cannon and fires it off to wherever it's going.
The battery is 40 feet high, is made of solid masonry and contained rooms for a garrison of 30. The battery gun was also used as a balloon base during the war.
What's a balloon base?
They would have a hot air balloon tied to a rope. They would have a lookout soldier in the balloon, so they can look out all across Loch Swilly. During World War I, Loch Swilly was full of warships.
It lay idle until the 1980s, when the Rathmullan Enterprise Group repaired the building and established a heritage centre, which opened in 1990.